I am Vasily Solotkov. I am professor of High School of Economics and at the same time, director of the Banking Institute. And Banking Institute is a faculty in the High School of Economics. I am PhD and I am supervisor of two master programs, which we are presenting today. Let me switch on the presentation, if you don't mind. You can see my picture and Ulyana Dentsova. She is the manager of those programs. And if you will become our student, definitely we will get in touch with her because she is a great boss, organizing all the stuff. And besides me and Ulyana, today we will see Sergey Zakharov. He is our faculty member. He is CFA, and he is actually from the field, real field. He is working in Gazprombank, in the finance department. And we will have two students today. Fatima, she graduated from Financial Analyst, and she is working for the Central Bank of Russia. And she left, I think, like 3 years ago, yeah? Fatima, you quit. You graduated from our program.
Yes, hello. Actually, I graduated in 2016, so it's almost 7 years past already.
The time is flying so fast.
Yes.
And you graduated from Financial Analyst, and we don't have graduates from our finance program. We have only first year program, and Kyung from South Korea would share his opinion with us, how it's going. So that's actually the program for today. But first of all, I should say several words about the Banking Institute. The Institute is working for almost 26 years. And we have more than 6,000 graduates from long-run programs. And we have three programs affiliated with the CFA Institute. What does it mean? I would explain a little bit later. First of all, what I should tell you, financial analyst, this is according to many surveys, that's profession of the future. Why? Because now you can see that the world is changing. On the basis of IT technology, a lot of jobs are disappearing. Could such a thing happen to financial analyst? My strong belief, no. Why? Because a financial analyst is doing, first of all, very interesting job. Second, this job is not the same every day. It's always changing. So it's almost impossible to make an algorithm for financial analysis. And financial analysts, he is touching different spheres of economy. He is dealing with investment banking. He is dealing with industry, with agriculture, with financial markets. So he must understand all the processes, must evaluate them, and to find the most efficient way how to solve the problems. What could be the opportunities of the programs? What are the benefits? I told you that these are CFA affiliation programs. What does it mean? First of all, we are attracting for applied courses faculty members from the field with certificates. First of all, CFA certificates. And this thing provides us a fellowship for our students to pass CFA exams with a discount of 75%. Besides it, CFA Institute on complementary basis is providing us with their textbooks. So every year we have a new textbooks and we're providing those textbooks to our faculty. So they are upgraded just in time. Besides it, you should take into account that CFA body of knowledge is based on the real demand of the market, and it is updated on the annual basis. And we, to fulfill the program requirements, have an audit on our program also on the yearly basis. And now we are doing this audit, and we should submit it all the papers till the 30th of May. We have a number of, besides, you know, all the contacts of the Higher School of Economics, we have our personal foreign partners. And our students can participate in exchange programs with Siena University, that's in Italy, University of Applied Science in Vienna, University of Katowice, and a double degree program with Lancaster University Management School. In some cases, such kind of, you know, exchange is supported by Erasmus grants, which means that going to this or that university, you can get sponsorship from EC. We have international master weeks, and I think Fatima participated in one of those. Yes? Just maybe you'll say when you will have your presentation, a couple of words about it. It's quite interesting. We are gathering students from different countries, mostly Europe, but for last 3 years, we had also participants from China. And all the students were doing different projects. Being at the Banking Institute, you will get all the support of HSE. First of all, that HSE library, where you have incredible number of journals, magazines, different subscriptions, and you can get access to those library either personally visiting it or doing it online. It's up to you. And actually, definitely it depends on the program. Alumni career path units, we have alumni club on our programs. Besides it, there is a career center at the HSE. And our graduates are working in, you can see the logos here, in different financial institutions in Russia or outside Russia. It could be international institutes, international companies, or it could be Russian companies. Then I would speak about financial analyst program. So please keep in mind, this is on-campus program. Because program finance, this is a 100% online program. But in both programs, the language of instructions is English. And duration of the program is 2 years in both cases. That's curriculum. The curriculum actually derived from the CFA body of knowledge with some added foundation courses, that's like macroeconomics, advanced econometrics and theory and finance, and some electives which are not the part of body of knowledge of the CFA Institute, but which could be interesting for the students. And being a student, you can choose electives on the first and on the second year. And later on, we will send to you the link with this presentation, so you will have time to figure out what kind of courses we are providing for the program. That's our faculty members. And as I mentioned to you, we are trying to attract as much as possible chapter holders of the CFA Institute. But besides, definitely, we also rely upon the faculty from the High School of Economics. So you can see, you know, both. Some of them are lecturers from HSE, and some of them are specialists, lecturers, I would say professors, visiting professors from different companies. That's statistics of the last year from which countries our students came, their gender, and the ratio between foreign and international students. So you can see it. That's where they came from. You can see that most of them have a different background, but the largest share is economics. Then goes mathematics and management. But you know, I can predict that we will have the questions that, for example, if what is happening to me if, for example, I have education which is not connected with economics. So it's not actually so important what was your previous background. Definitely. For you, it will be much easier to study if you know mathematics. But if you don't know, I will help you. We'll have different courses which would be able to upgrade you. So don't worry. But you will have to work hard. Fees and discounts. So the program is fully tuition based. We don't have any fellowship. But we have discounts for this program. And please keep in mind that the price is fixed. It is not changed. For the price is fixed for 2 years of your study. And we have 10% discounts for graduates of HSE. And besides that, we have also early bird discount. So please, you know, make research on our discounts and try to make your spending of your money more efficient. Then Master of Finance program. This is online program, but generally the content is the same. So these are some minor changes. And please keep in mind that graduating from this program, you will get a diploma. We will not be mentioned that this is online program. So you will get the same kind of diploma as those students who graduated from the on-campus program. And the language of the program is English. Here you can see the program content. That's slightly different, but basically the same as program content of financial analyst. You see faculty members, some of them are the same and some are not participating, some of them are not participating in both programs. But you see that many of our faculty members are CFA. Fees and discounts, it's more complicated, especially for foreign students. So being in Russia, we must set up the price in Russian rubles. So in this sense, the price is fixed. But if you are paying in US dollars, the amount you are paying depends on the exchange rate. So currently, without any discounts, that's roughly 10,000 US dollars per year in US dollars. But we have discounts for students from Russia and former all former Soviet Union countries. The price is 375,000, which is roughly 5,400 US dollars at the current exchange rate. And for developing countries that's based on the qualification of the World Bank, they are all developing countries, excluding upper level developing countries. So for them, the ruble price is roughly, sorry. So it's roughly 500,000, and in US dollars, that's approximately 8,400 US dollars per year. But once more, it depends on the exchange rate. How to apply? We have a different procedure for Russian, for those who has Russian citizenship and for foreign students. All students must provide us their portfolio, but Russian students must either to provide us with certificates that they have knowledge in English, and you can see those certificates, or in case they don't have such kind of certificates, they must take an exam. For international students, it's a little bit easier situation because they either should prove us that English is their native language, or that in case their previous education was done in English. Or, for example, they don't have any certificates and but they know English. In this case, it will be interview with me. So no exam for foreign students. That's the composition of the portfolio. You can see that every item provides you with number of credits. So try to submit all your papers to increase the number of points you can get to your portfolio. That's what additional scores could be added to your portfolio. That's in case you have a prior work experience. Or you have previously passed any level of CFA exam. or you participated in a different competition, or you provided, you have publications, or you participated in conferences. So all this stuff is providing you additional credits. The set of portfolio is the same for both programs. So you could apply for both programs and then to choose which kind of program is better for you. How to apply, it's easy. A little bit different for two programs, but for Master of Finance, you can apply right now. And for Financial Analyst, starting from June 20. But besides it, we have early, so-called early acceptance. So you could provide your documents right now in both cases. And here are our contacts. So what I suggest, definitely we'll have questions, but before you will ask us questions, I would like to provide floor to other participants because I am not the only one. And if you don't mind, I will start with Sergey. Sergey, what is your experience teaching of the program? Programs, I would say.
Well, good evening, or good morning, or good afternoon, everybody. I would like to start with few words that were said by a wise man who lived more than 2,000 years ago, and his words and lessons are still actual nowadays. And by the way, they form an important part of modern Chinese culture. As you can guess, his name was Confucius. He was a famous Chinese philosopher, and he said very wise thing. Apply knowledge that you have learned. Isn't it happiness? I can't help but agree with these words. So good education, if it's well learned and applied, brings happiness, indeed. And it also brings career, brings money. So as Mr. Solovkov has introduced, my name is Sergey Zakharov, and I am an investment banker with more than 16 years of experience. So I have 7 years of successful collaboration with the High School of Economics for MBA and master's programs. And for these 7 years, I had a chance to ensure that this is indeed one of the best, if not the best programs in finance that you can learn in this country. So talking about program and education in particular, I would like to highlight first some key features, some criteria which characterize indeed best education nowadays. Well, the first thing is that education is an ongoing lifetime process. So you cannot think that you will complete the master's program and will end education. So master's program is just one of the steps in your future, in your career, and in your life. However, to have better progress, you have to have a strong basis. And master's program of High School of Economics can form such a basis. And second, education cannot be separated into theory itself and practice itself. So substantial part of education shall be represented by teachers from the field with solid practical experience. And in the program of High School of Economics, you can find also the speeches, strong program, lots of practice, and of course, a team of really bright, really strong professionals. Most of them have 10 years experience, 15 years of practical experience. And on my side, I can add that in case you enter the program and, for example, choose my course, and my course is dedicated to investments and to mergers and acquisitions and to investment banking. And I will try to share things that cannot be found in books or articles. And they can be learned only by several years of hard practical work in real investment bank. So when I teach my lessons and when other teachers teach their courses, they try to share something that cannot be simply read and learned. They try to give you the very nature of the subject. And of course, nowadays education is not only about knowledge itself, it's about network, it's about working in groups, it's about communication, and about practice and testing some hypotheses. So under some of the courses, you will have to work in groups, you will have to make projects, and you will have a chance to make things in groups that cannot be simply done by one person. So this is a real practice, real basis for some real work situations. I can give you an example. For example, if when I am a job interviewer in investment bank, I pay attention to two key things. First thing is about motivation of the candidate. And the second is about demonstration of actual knowledge and ability to learn quickly. So I believe all of you here who are online now are highly motivated people, just because you are here and now, by the way. So the trick in the career is to have success in the second part, about demonstration of actual knowledge and ability to learn quickly. I strongly believe that after you complete the course, which is, by the way, very well diversified, you will be able to become such a person who will win job interview, real job interview. I also believe that even in our time of technologies, machine learning, and all that stuff, being experienced and well-educated in finance is indeed important, because theory of investment and finance gives answer to three key questions. First question is about placement of different assets in different parts of economy and the world. Second is about valuation of assets. And the third is about managing risks. So being financial analyst is about making decisions. And this is actually the thing that I believe will not be replaced by machines, at least for the next 20 or 30 years. So you'll have plenty of time to apply your skills after you complete your education. And in 20 or 30 years, I guess we'll have a chance to learn something new, because today education is a lifetime ongoing process. So here in this master's program, you will have a chance to learn different diversified disciplines. You will have a chance to meet really bright teachers. You will have a chance to have good network and work in groups. And you will have a chance to have a lot of practice and then apply this all. So I don't know actually what to add. I would like to wish you all a bright and interesting career and education. And for those of you who decide to enter the program, I will be looking forward to seeing you on my course and will try personally to give you the best of my knowledge. So that's it. Thank you.
Sergey, thank you very much. Fatima, are you ready?
Yes.
What kind of skills you are working acquired on the program are you using in your working in the central bank?
Yes, hello to everybody. I will try to tell you about my experience above what said Sergey. So I entered the master degree after graduating from a bachelor program of economics. And I had two tasks. I wanted to have a complex knowledge of what I've learned on bachelor degree, to have a master program, and also to combine this study with my work. So this program was just perfect for me. And financial analysis is wide range of techniques you use. So while I studied, I worked in the central bank and used these techniques on the other side as a regulator, because I'm working in the department of banking regulation and analysis, and we are implementing central bank's laws and other standards to help credit institutions, banking groups, and holdings to operate their financial risks properly. During my work, I implemented the Basel standards. It's a worldwide standards, which are also used in Russia to evaluate risks that financial institutions take on. And during this program, you will have studies on Basel regulations. Also, you will study an accounting in FRS and EIS accounting. And we also use it in our work now. So we implement some accounting standards, and my knowledges, which I got on master degree, they helped me really, really much, because while you're studying, you're improving your financial English, you know, all the terminology, all the financial words and so on, and you will understand the financial laws, financial standards really good. So if you are not going to be a financial analyst, if you want to be a supervisor, for example, in the central bank of your country, it's also a useful tool. Also, while studying, I had 2 weeks of exchange program. It was in Vienna, and it was a really good opportunity, because there were different students from different countries. We have a collaboration, and for 2 weeks we were first studying about how to evaluate a firm, how to examine what's the financial situation of a company, and then we have a real case studies and represented our case studies. So it was a really nice experience. We have a certificate after that, which you can also show when you're applying to a job. What else? Really good lectures and teachers from the fields. We had case studies which were implemented right now. You can go to your job and implement all the techniques and tools of financial analysis which you're studying. There are not so much hours of academic knowledges, because it was on a bachelor degree, you had it. Now you have a combined information about what is really necessary, which you can use and which you can feel while operating a business or evaluating some financial situation of different companies. Also, really during studies, I've already worked, and what can I say, it isn't easy, because the study is rather complicated. You have to really be you really have to study there, so you can't just sit and listen what lecturers say and so on. No, you have to improve your knowledges, so it's not a waste of time, definitely, but you can combine it with your work. You can study your job experience, which is a plus, because after 2 years you will have 2 year job experience and also a diploma. I can say that the decision to have this master program was really a good one. It helped me to get some contacts with different students. We have an alumni channel in Telegram. It really helps now because all students are communicating. We are have conversation about our jobs, ask questions. Also, we can help each other. Like now this year, some people wanted to migrate in other countries, and there are students who already live, for example, in Germany, and they are suggested how to do it, and so on. So, really, the alumni communication is it's like a team which is with you for your lifetime. If you're interested in program which helps to get complex knowledge in financial analysis, if you want to have a CFA exam and to combine it with work, I think this program suits you really well. If you have any questions, I am going to answer it. Thank you very much.
Fatima, thank you very much. And I just would like to remind you that Fatima graduated from the on-campus program Financial Analyst.
Yes.
Yeah. And now I would like to give a floor to Kyung. He is attending our finance program, which is online. And what is your just experience? Why you choose this program, and what kind of, you know, useful knowledge you are getting being in this program?
Yes, hello everyone. My name is Kyung Se, and I am originally from Korea and first year student in Master of Finance program. So the biggest motivator for me to apply for this program was how flexible it was, how I could both combine working full time and being a student full time. When I applied, I had bachelor in English, but I had strong passion for finance. And I just wanted to tell everyone today that if you have a strong passion for finance, of course, if you have bachelor in economics or finance, it would help a lot. But still, if you have a strong passion, I think it's a good opportunity to apply and enhance your skills. From English to finance. It was a big leap for me. I want to introduce one program that I attended called Vienna Advanced Topics in Asset Management Program. So this was an asset management program hosted by Applied Sciences University, EFI Vienna, and Raiffeisen Bank. I applied last winter and was chosen to represent HSC. So I flew from Russia to attend this program on site. And it was a great opportunity in both career and networking. But the important part is our task was to build China equity portfolio and optimize it. Or you could think, maybe you guys know this, but ETF program. And I received one, which is excellent in this program, among with all students from all over the world who are actually already working in finance and second year of master's, they were. So I just wanted to show that this program will give you a competitive edge in a global level. And whatever your bachelor was, if you study hard and follow up with the program, you can achieve such competitive edge. For now,
Okay, thank you so much. And now, please, our guests, you are welcome to ask the questions about the program, about the university, about the institute, whatever. Please feel free to ask us. And just more, if you there is a special option for you. If you need a special consultation, please let us know, and you can meet with me. Okay, Maria.
Hi, sir.
Yeah.
I have like a general question. In the beginning, you said that you don't think that like financial analyst job will be replaced because it's you know, there's no like algorithm. You said something along those lines. So what jobs like in the finance sphere do you think like you know, will be replaced soon, like are not worth pursuing?
You know, if I understood your questions question correctly, some of jobs in finance are replaced now. For example, trader. If you take, you know, the trader on the stock market, and now most of the job is done by robots. The same, you know, happens step by step on the foreign exchange market. But financial analyst is, you know, more wide. And I think maybe Sergey would answer better this question, because that's, you know, my view from academy. And Sergey, what is your view from the practice, from the field?
Well, if you are talking about trading, indeed, some handwork, technical work is replaced, but anyway, most of the algorithms are still created by people. So who programs the computer for trading? Of course, there are more progressive things like machine learning and all that stuff, but anyway, behind the machine, there is a man or a woman, a human. and it's in trading, in some things like investment banking, like mergers and acquisition or some complex transactions. We do not see such a replacement, actually, because some complicated things still require creativity. And in my opinion, creativity is a derivative from knowledge and motivation to apply. So, as I said, we still have 20, 30 years.
Okay, Sergey, thank you. And Ryabchenko, Max, please.
Yes, thank you. Please, can you describe, you have just 2 weeks for exchanging with your partners, I mean period. And the second one, will we have real chance to use your program of exchanging in the next year, in this year?
Max, thank you for your question. Because normally we have three types of exchange. First, this is 2 weeks, actually 2 weeks. That's 1 week. Master program, which is taking place by different countries like Germany, Italy, Poland. Second type is that's semester exchange. And third type is double degree, that's with Lancaster University. What will happen this year? I told you that this is a good question, because maybe you noticed that we don't have any direct flights anymore to Europe. And this is, you know, beyond me. I can't, unfortunately, influence on it. But you can participate either online, or you can participate, you know, using not direct flights, but, you know, flights with connections. Normally, this is Istanbul or Dubai, or participate online. That's what actually could be done.
Okay, thank you.
And okay, Snadia Ahmad, please, you're welcome. You should switch on your mic. We can't hear you. You should switch on your mic. I think you switched it already. We can't hear you. Please write your question, okay? Write your question in the chat.
Can you hear me?
Yes, now I can hear you.
Okay, so thank you for all the presentation today. It's a lot of information. So kind of I have two questions. The first one, do I able to apply for financial aid from Russian government? I used to do that 2 years ago and I get exceptions. So I'm wondering if I can do that in this year. And do I have available time to do that? Because I know the process can take a little bit while, like a month or 2 months. And I know the program gonna start middle of next month. That's the first question. Second question is related to financial engineer. Do we have anything related to do how to coding or machine learning?
Okay, first, we don't have, you know, any fellowship on this program. If you know how to get money from the Russian government, you are welcome. But the program itself is not providing fellowship. It's totally pay-based program. Concerning machine learning, you will have a second year elective course on machine learning, so you're welcome.
Perfect. And there's no any requirement for coding background, because I have financial background and I don't have
any financial background. You will get additional points, additional credits to your portfolio. You will get additional credits to your portfolio if you have financial background. If you have besides it working experience in finance, you will get even more credits to your portfolio. Okay? Please, other questions?
Awesome. Okay, thank you so much.
Okay. Please. Who else? Please don't hesitate to ask us. It's a good opportunity to figure out what kind of services we can provide you, what you will get after graduation of the course.
I have another question.
Okay, you're welcome.
Do you have any statistics regarding how many of your graduates of the program get employment after they graduate?
Honestly, I don't know any graduate who didn't get an employment. Because first of all, if we are speaking about both programs, it doesn't matter. We prefer that our students not only taking classes, but they're working. Good news about it is that they know what to study. They are much more motivated. Bad news about it is that it is quite difficult. But what is clear for me that most of our graduates, after graduation, they are changing their position. If you are not speaking, switch off your mic. So most of our graduates after graduation are changing their position. They're growing, that's normal. So they're choosing other companies. And they have a good opportunity to do that because most of their professors are from the field and one of the incentive of professor to teach you the course is to find a good student, honestly speaking. And second story is that you will have a lot of communication with other students. And normally Fatima just told you that we have chats, I could confirm it. We have chats where students are speaking with each other and also providing each other different opportunities.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Guys, other questions?
Hello. Yes, I have one question.
Evgeny, okay.
Yes, thanks, me. Unfortunately, I missed the whole presentation part. I just connected like 10 minutes ago. I just have one question. You have special courses for preparation for CFA, which starts in October this year.
Evgeny, the line is a pure disaster.
I wrote it in chat. I wrote it in chat. Okay.
Okay, please write down your question in the chat. It's pure disaster. I at least, you know, I didn't understand anything. Sorry. Other questions?
I think there is one question in the chat from Samuel. Okay.
I don't see it.
He asks about how the current situation can affect the study.
Fatima, I don't see the question. Could you read it?
Yes, of course. Yes, there is a question from Samuel. Hello, team. I'm Samuel Lekai from Ghana. I want to know if the war happening in Ukraine will affect the offline studies and also if there is a scholarship available for this program. Thank you.
Yes, first, you know, I told you that there is no, unfortunately, any scholarship for this program. And one of the reason because you know we are attracting people from the industry and we have to pay them compensation which should you know be equal you know for the compensation working in the industry. And how the situation with Ukraine affect? Definitely it would affect because currently, you know, Russia is imposed a lot of sanctions. But I think it is not affecting the cost by itself. It could affect, you know, the logistic problems, whatever, but not the content of the course.
Okay, it's Evgeny again. I moved to another place. Can you hear me now? Loud and clear. No? Hello.
Hello, yeah, but Evgeny, the same problem. I can't hear you.
I wrote the question in the chat about CFA courses.
Okay, I've got it. I've got it here. I see.
I can read it if it's needed.
No, I found it. Do you have offline courses for CFA in October? Evgeny, what do you mean offline courses for CFA? Guys, these are master programs. That's not courses for preparation for CFA exam. In October, we will have a preparation course for CFA exam, but it's not this program. It's other program where students are getting trained to pass CFA exam. And we will have them in hybrid mode. So some of them are attending the class and some of them are online. And the same, by the way, we are doing on the financial analyst program. So you have option either to attend the campus or you have option to be online. This took place after COVID when some of the students could not get to the campus. And besides it, we had some restrictions on campus. Now all the restrictions has gone away, but we've got this experience. Now we are teaching in both ways. Okay, other questions?
Yeah, so I got questions. So if I'm in the campus, the tuition is gonna cover the housing too?
No, you should. We have some facilities for the students. You are paying below the market price, but you are paying yourself. So it's not included in your payment for the program. It'll be separate. Guys, other questions?
Hello, Vasily Mikhailovich. I have a question concerning the study hours, the study time. Well, speaking about the Master of Finance program, at what time exactly do the classes begin, and on which weekday?
You mean finance or
financial? Master of Finance program.
The classes starts on 1st of September in all cases for all programs. But the difference is that in financial analyst, you have daily classes. Normally that's in the evening or Saturday. And in the finance, you have a webinar on a course per week. Sometimes there are two webinars because if the subject is complicated and students are not able to understand what is going, they are asking us, and in this case, we are providing them with additional webinars. But mostly, most of the time, you have a pre-recorded video, you have pre-recorded cases, and you are learning when it is most convenient for you. That's one of the advantages of the online program.
So we do not have an exact time
exact time for webinar.
So it just takes place when it's scheduled.
It's when it's scheduled, but it's normally it's once or twice a week.
So the reason why I'm asking is that I'm going to apply for this online program, and I'm going to work alongside studying, and won't be a stumbling block for my working experience.
No, you see that your working experience would be part of your portfolio and would provide you additional credits.
No, I'm speaking about the that beginning from September, I will be working in my home country, and
that's okay.
Yeah, I know. And there is a time gap between Moscow and my country, so sometimes should I attend classes on weekdays?
It's all manageable because in the finance group from the very beginning we had students from Korea and from the United States. Mm-hmm. And in this case, we started from two webinars for different time zones. And then students decided that one time zone for them is okay, as far as I remember.
So there are two schedules for certain time zones here?
I think, yeah, because we are doing how it must be convenient for you. We are not restricted in this.
Okay, now I see, thank you.
If you would apply in August, in this process, guys, first of all, the earlier you would apply, you will get a discount. Please keep it in mind. And then you should take about the visa process, which is taking a certain period of time. As far as I remember, that's maybe Ulyana would correct me. This is about, could be 40 days. So please do it beforehand. Otherwise, you would miss some classes on campus, if it is on campus program. If it is online program, it doesn't matter because you are not applying for the visa.
Actually, may I add on the Master of Finance program?
Mm-hmm.
As a student in Master of Finance program, I think I can clear up some questions people have about working full time and attending classes. I am also working full time as co-founder of a company. And when I actually began the program, I was studying in Korea. So basically it was manageable to catch up to all the pre-recorded lectures and classes. Taking tests is also on your own time. And from what I understand, most students in our program are working full time and managing the studies in their own time.
Guys, we will send the link to the presentation, don't worry. Other questions, if you have any, or it's all clear at this stage? Okay, guys, if it is all clear, I would like to thank all the participants, first, our students, former and current students, our professor, my employees of the Banking Institute, and all the participants. So please welcome. Programs are really interesting and exciting. And we are waiting for you. Bye. If you don't have any other questions.
Thank you.